you're still watching Urban Television and we're still here with these lovely ladies who are still tackling sexual harassment because it's increasing. Like I told you, a month back, a lady was complaining on Twitter and she was burnt. Just a week back, one has been burnt to death by a jealous boyfriend. And someone out there who is standing, I won't mention his name, is saying you cannot be raped by your boyfriend. Please, before we go ahead, you can be raped by your husband. And you know, it's weird. People are like, how are you raped by your partner? You can.
As long as it does not involve consent.
Yes.
That's rape.
Yes,
that's rape.
Mm. You're not entitled to touch anyone if they do not
they
want
don't want to be touched. Yeah. So now, we've talked about ways to help, you know, karate and, you know, going to different institutions, lawyers. But now, don't you feel like after you clean up the people who are with the victims, what about the people who are doing this? Do you approach them and be like, you say, well, you did this? Because it's solving the problem. Anisha has been raped. I've come out. I'm trying to clean up myself. But there's still predators out there. You've left them.
True.
No one is helping. What is happening?
Yeah, well, definitely. We look at when someone files a complaint to us and they list a name, we have to talk to this person and find out and be like, you see, for example, like at campus, if this lecturer is being complained about, we have to talk to him. Go through the HR system in the university and say that there's a complaint about this person. Talk to him, see what can be done, see if he can change. Yeah, so that is what.
And like I said before, we have a legal, we have some lawyers in place that are going to be helping us with this. Because maybe we're also looking at some people maybe who are, like you talked about, like someone may come out of the blue and accuse someone, like maybe this one raped me and there's no evidence. You get the whole point.
Let's first talk about more of the story. Let's go back on that story of the lady who was burned. Did you know her personally? Do you know her parents?
Yeah, actually, yeah, I do. She's my, her parents were family friends, like sometime back when we were growing up in nursery. But when I heard about that story, I actually didn't know she was the one, not until, because basically they were saying she's called Kemba Wazi and she's called Kevin Runji. So it didn't like actually take my attention, not until when I found out the day for the burial and yeah, she was like a sister to me.
So let's go into the details. How did they even find the body?
I don't really know, but
how did they find the body and how did they find out that it was a boyfriend who burnt her? Because it's weird, you know hostel rooms. I was in hostel, it's room after room after room. So by the time they're burning someone, I feel like the partner, someone next door should be able to hear a scream, because burning someone to death, you can hear.
To make something clear, she wasn't in hostel.
She was not in hostel.
Yeah, she was staying in Bugorobi, around Bugorobi. But how they definitely found out, of course, once you set someone on fire, definitely some people will tell something is wrong. And it has already, we can't accuse someone like it's a boyfriend on national TV. It has not been confirmed that it's a boyfriend, but he's the number one suspect.
So it's not yet confirmed, but he's the number
one. And that's why Sisters Keeper now has to. That's why people out there have to come up and support so that we can see how to deal with these people. We can see how to find them out.
Okay.
Find out whether, like, the right person.
So have any of you been victims before?
Yeah, definitely. I will not deny that. I'm very sure 99% of the girls of my age or above have really been victims of.
How does sexual harassment start off? Does it start off sometimes at a younger stage when the you know, sexual education is something that's very crucial to us, but we don't go through it because we're in a, you know, our culture,
you know,
people are scared
about it.
Exactly.
Yeah, this is something they don't want to talk
but these
about.
Are things that kids as young as 9 go through.
Yes,
you get it. So
yes.
I feel like by the time they reach campus, some of them have been sexually harassed.
Yeah, and some actually sexually harassed and they don't even know that this is sexual harassment. You know, I believe there's a fine line between hitting on someone and assaulting someone. So there's a really big gap in being educated and knowing what is right and what is not okay. So definitely all of us have experienced it, at least through work, or you may be going like downtown to do some shopping and someone is going to touch you inappropriately.
Yes,
because
speaking
they know
of
nothing
downtown,
is going to happen.
Honestly, you go downtown, you can't even dress up.
Yes.
Like, if you, even though you put on jeans and a top,
yes,
they'll be
yes.
like, sister, watch your yamba devubi, and
thank
they'll
you.
Grab you and pull you.
But
and
maybe if we can educate those people, like you said, sister, maybe they will learn how to keep a sister safe. That's what we're trying to do.
That is that, yeah. So yeah. We came up with this, by the way, we didn't talk about the origin of this organization. Who came up? How long has this organization been running for?
Actually, the person who came up with an idea is a gentleman, the director of this organization.
Is a man.
Yes.
Yeah,
yay.
Yeah, it's a man. Which was so nice.
personally, he told us that he has his friend who he saw that was going through gender-based violence throughout campus, and he realized that this is an issue. So he started the organization and he talked to us. We loved the idea and we're like, yes, we're going to come on board. So he was previously doing community work, going to schools in rural areas. And when we came onto board, we realized that there's actually a gap with universities, institutions of learning and work environment. So right now we're focusing on pre-campus, campus and post-campus.
Wow, yeah. This is nice because I'd love my daughter to be friends with people like you. Yeah, from a younger age, okay. Because so they start touching them at a, it's really, really bad and it's worrying. This girl being burned to death has really shocked me. But we're almost coming to the end of the show, so any last views you want to take up on, any last words that you want to let us know?
Oh, I want to shout out to all the parents out there. Maybe they can try and, when you're raising your sons, maybe you can try and put that gender-based violence thing into them, so that maybe when you're out there, of course when it starts from family, if you're a mother and you teach your son not to rape, then you definitely...
How do you teach your son to rape?
Not to rape.
It's not to rape, but how do you teach your son to rape?
That's what I'm saying. You have to give them a background of gender-based violence as you're raising them, so that they know a woman is very, very important in the society. And you cannot just... A woman cannot be walking and slap her ass.
That's what I'm trying to say.
So definitely, yeah. when you have your son displayed out there, you don't have to be worried about your daughter. And you shall have a...
That is very true. Any last
views? Well, my last view, I would like to talk about feminism. People think feminism is just all about females, but even men can be feminists too. So I just want to say that we should all stand up for each other. We all have mothers, sisters, everyone that we care about.
Men can be feminists too?
Yes, they
Let's
can.
Let's talk about that. How are men feminists?
Just feminism is all about believing in equality for and respecting women's rights. So if we can do that, I believe we can have a better society.
But you know, people say that feminists are unfair. They only want to be feminists when it comes to job, pay, what. When you tell them to pay their bills, that things are not equal.
Yeah, but when we talk about the definition of feminism, leave these things of, yes, you're going out, you're buying my meal, but when we talk about the basics and rights and why, then it really breaks it down for us and it shows us that we can all be feminists, whether male or female. I mean, because even us as women, we do respect men's rights. We do respect them. So they should
also
respect
us too.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for being part of the show. That is all we had for you. Remember, this is a big issue. If you're tapping that ass and they're not consented, if you're those people who say, sister, please, mutuyambe, respect us. Honestly,
yes,
I am tired of going downtown and I have to wrap myself in 10 different attires because I don't tap me.
Thank you.
Even though you wrap it up, they are so disrespectful. Even on a Friday, they say hajat, my
Thank
time.
You.
Until like even when I'm dressed,
my size.
What? I am not showing you any booty. So why are you looking at me?
I know.
You gentlemen out there, even you ladies, some of you, you look at, because honestly, when I look at a man do that, me, I tell you, we look at things happening and we just keep quiet. As women, we should stand up for each other. Say no to men who are downtown in taxi parks trying to touch us and you young gentlemen in campus trying to rape young girls. That is not right. That is all we have for you. Bye.